Welcome back, baseball fans, to this elimination of the Detroit Tigers video. And what you're looking at, first of all, is last year's Detroit Tiger team that went to a World Series. That's right, 30-29, because they won their division with a losing record. Then they got hot in the playoffs. Still, that's a lot of baseball for a 500 kind of team. Last year, 30-29 Tigers, 253, 348 are the big numbers. And looking at this data, some of the things that jump out. Willie Horton, 20 homer, 53 RBI. Gates Brown, 333 batting average. Dick McAuliffe hit .199. The team did not steal a base in 59 games. Let's see, Jim Northrup had 18 doubles. Fun stuff like that. Pitching. Joe Coleman emerged as the ace, even though he was the number three starter on opening day. 11-5, 286. Mickey Lolich, 9-6, 296. Denny McClain had a rough year, had a rough time of things. John Hiller and Timmerman held up in the bullpen. And that is your 2021 Tigers. A year later, they just were eliminated by the Milwaukee Brewers, and the batting average is almost identical. But you notice, in 22 fewer games. So those same guys are still around, I mentioned. Willie Horton this year hit .219 with 5 homers. Far cry from a year ago. Gates Brown did pretty much a similar thing. Northrup, 9 homer, 23 RBI, .297. Mickey Stanley probably should have played more, but most of that was against left-handed pitching. A real, real rough time for Al Kaline. 242, 3 homer, but a stunning 7 RBI in 149 at-bats and 37 games. That probably would have been an all-time low in that category for Al. And pitching, Joe Coleman, well, he turned to be a 4-7 starter. Lolich was 6-3. They were okay, but nothing better than okay. They had 8 complete games. Howie Reed had an ERA below 2. He was not called upon in that extra inning loss to the Brewers. They called on Bill Slayback instead. And frankly, Bill Slayback actually was a Tiger, and Howie Reed was an Expo. So that was one of the reasons. He wasn't used. Anyway, folks, this is all about eliminating the Detroit Tigers. Let's take a look at their card set. So, what was it, 3 years ago? So 3 years ago, they won the World Series, beating the Dodgers. 2 years ago, they got knocked out of the playoffs by Baltimore. Baltimore won the World Series. Last year, the Tigers beat Baltimore in the playoffs, went to the World Series, and lost to the Mets. So, there's a lot of data here over the last couple years showing a team basically 48 wins and 47 losses. In a two-year analysis of the team. So let's see, where are the Tigers now? What happens to this team? We talked about how a lot of their hitters still produce into their 30s, which is pretty good. That should be good news. They age very well, do the Tigers. They age like fine wine. Must be playing in the small Tiger Stadium. Has a lot to do with that. So 8 1970 cards will be disappearing from the stack. And it's, you know, actually, it's not that bad. It's no reason to cry if you're a Tiger fan, because a lot of those guys will be replaced. And the guys coming back are the guys I was just talking about, guys who age well, like fine wine. And there you see all your Tiger heroes. Horton, we'll start him at DH for now. Cash at first. The Stevenson guy can catch. And then you have McAuliffe at second base. I'll make Gates Brown your DH. Let's do this again. So Gates Brown could be a DH. Cash at first. Or Stevenson, right? Stevenson's catching. Right? And then Cash at first, McAuliffe at second. You don't have a third baseman or a shortstop, but you got an outfield. You have Horton in left, Mickey Stanley in center. and Northrop and Wright. So again, you're in the same boat you were in at the beginning of this year. You didn't have a third baseman and shortstop. So for the third year in a row, they're going to have to figure that out. Third base and shortstop. Pitching. There's five dudes here. And, oh yeah, that's fine. You got your guys. Yeah. Volich, 72. You got two more years of this card. Coleman, one more year of this card. 20-game winner. That's 42 wins right there. Turnman had a nice year this year with the 72 card. Slayback was all right with a 72 card. That 72 Tiger team went to the playoffs. And the Steve Keeley was a White Sox player, added to the bullpen. Seven hitters, five pitchers, pretty balanced, looking pretty good. Not too bad. We know, you know, there's some names missing, but we'll probably replace those missing names. Let's go see what the Tigers do with those eight guys from 1970. Who do they keep? Who do they waive? And who do they retire? All right, let's go check out what these Tigers do, as they just want to pick up where they left off, possibly even improve. But yeah, this is an outlier. Baltimore and Detroit were really stunned by what happened in the 2022 season. Be interesting to see how both teams rebound next year. Similar boats here. So looking at the eight guys, five hitters and three pitchers. The first guy was a one-year pickup. It's Cleet Boyer. And so Cleet would not win all these gold gloves he should have won because Brooks Robinson played in the American League. So yeah. But anyway, Cleet got one in for the Braves in 69. So there's that. He does come back for a 71 season. And it's very similar. It's actually not too bad. It's 108 at-bat plate appearances for the Braves. Does the card exist, is the question, because it's only 108 plate appearances. Let's take a look at the roster sheet for 71 for the Atlanta Braves and see if Cleet Boyer's card is in here. And in the infielders, I don't know who they have at third. Oh, Darrell Evans, yeah. Extra players. Oh, that's mean. Dusty Baker, Gil Gerardo. Well, that's a real shame. That's a real shame. That would have been a decent-looking card. But no Cleet Boyer card in 1971 for Strat-O-Matic. Boo. Boo Strat for that. Baker, Gerardo, McQueen, and Pretty. And Atlanta up here. Didier, King, Cepeda, Evans, Mayon, Perez, Versailles, Williams, Aaron Gard, Jackson, and Lum. What a shame. So, yeah, it was only 30 games. But he has an interesting line. I mean, he had six home runs and 108 plate appearances. It would have been a fun card to have. Unfortunately, we do not have it. So, unfortunately, we have to retire Mr. Cleet Boyer. Sorry about that, Cleet. Final year, try to get a ring with the Tigers. Next guy, Ed Brinkman. He's got some MVP votes in here, folks. I'm not kidding. Washington Senator, went to Detroit. And there it is. See this? In 1972, nine MVP votes, or ninth in MVP votes, for the 203 Gold Glove shortstop of the Detroit Tigers at age 30. Interesting. He's going to be a Tiger, 71 through 74. And 74, he has 14 home runs. That might be the best year. But yeah, he's coming back. They need a solid shortstop. In their World Series year, they had bad shortstop play, which cost them. Even though they were worse this year, you can't blame that on Ed Brinkman. All right, next guy is Bill Freehand. He should probably be a keeper. Sure, Bill Freehand, of course. Look at all those All-Star appearances. Yeah. So we just wrapped up his 70 season, and the good news is he gets better with age. At age 29, he has a heck of a year in 71. He's an All-Star through 75. Lifetime Tiger, you gotta let him play all the way through the middle of the decade. So Will Freehand will be coming back. Next up, another no-brainer. This is all good news, folks. This is really good news for your Detroit Tigers. Your keepers are all guys you love in Detroit. And this is, of course, Hall of Famer Al Kaline. Look at all the All-Star appearances. You know, in 70 he missed, but in 71 he went to that All-Star game in his own stadium. 878 OPS. It's a heck of a card. 74 is even okay. So, yeah, plenty of time to figure out which year. That's not really important right now. It's just whether we're going to keep a guy, put him on waivers, or retire a guy. And we got three guys we like thus far. And I think I know the fourth one is going to be coming up a little bit later. Woody Woodward is the next player, assigned as a free agent off of the Reds. Woody played as a utility player, would play in the 70 series, I believe, against Baltimore with this 223 card, yeah. So he has a card, we believe he has a card in 71 with the Reds at 309 at-bats. Let's just double-check that. He's got to have a card to qualify for waivers, and he does. So we're putting old Woody on waivers to hook on with another team. Ed Brinkman's blocking him at shortstop anyway, as is Dick McCall's blocking him at second base. Pretty straightforward with three more guys left. We're going to go to a lefty starter who had a pretty decent couple of years, Les Cain. Les Cain for the Tigers. In 70, he has look at the whip in 3 years. It's almost identical. 71, he's a little bit worse though. And unfortunately for Les, he'll definitely have a card with that many innings. I'll just double check. I think the Tigers are going to say goodbye though. They have to, and you'll see why. They don't have room for Les Cain. They could trade him, but I don't think there's a big market for trading him, so they're going to put him on waivers. Next player, Howie Reed. Actually, wasn't a Tiger. How many Howies are there? A lot. Howie Reed, Expo. But before that, a KCA, a Dodger, Angel, Astro, Expo. Does he qualify for waivers in 56 innings in 1971 with the Expos? Howie Reed qualifies for waivers. That's nice. That's good for the league. That means that three of these guys get to find new homes instead of retirement. And lastly, in what should be the final keeper, another no-brainer, John Hiller. John Hiller, and actually his cards will get a lot better. We had a 70 card, which was okay. I had better than okay. He's got 104 innings. But he misses 71. But in 73, puts it all together with a .44 ERA and 38 saves, 4 MVP votes. 74, it's also good. 17-14. My goodness, 150 innings. 73 is better than 74, though. So, yeah, John Hiller. Now the Tigers will really have a... Yeah. So, looking at this, I think Ed Brinkman will get better, particularly defensively. Bill Freehand, we know he's got some... He'll do better. Kaline's got a better card. And John Hiller's got a much, much better card as a better closer than the card we just had. So, your Tiger keepers are all great. And so, if they add some rookies to this, they have a hole at third base. They could go look for Aurelio Rodriguez. Vegas owns Aurelio. They can open trade discussions and see if they can bring their Tiger, former California Angel and Detroit Tiger in the 70, to man third base, or they got to find another third base option. But outside of that, Tiger's looking good. Four really outstanding keepers for a Tiger team that does not get old. They play with old players very well. They age like fine wine in Detroit. That's it tonight for eliminating the Detroit Tigers. Thanks for checking this out. We'll see you next time.